So this is the determinant of an n by n matrix A. As we have seen, there are n factorial terms in this sum. And since n factorial grows very quickly as n increases, this expression is really hard to work with. So we're going to look at another way of computing the determinant, and in some cases, it can reduce the amount of work that we need to do. Let me first just define a notion. Let I and j be from the set 1 up to n, and we're going to define a open bracket I vertical bar j close bracket to be the matrix obtained from A by removing row I and column j of A. So let's look at an example. Suppose that my matrix A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So what would be A 1 vertical bar 1? So we're removing first row and first column. That leaves us with the matrix 5, 6, 8, 9. Let's look at another example. This time we look at A 3 vertical bar 2. So I'm removing row 3 and column 2. So that will leave us with the matrix 1 and 3 in the first row and 4 and 6 in the second row. So now with this defined, we can look at the cofactor formula for determinants. We first pick an I from 1 up to n. Then the determinant of A is given by the following. So it's a sum of n terms. The jth term looks like this. So minus 1 to the I plus j, aij, determinant of A, I, vertical bar, j. Now, how does this help us? Well, the key is that each of these determinants involves a matrix that is of size 1 less than the original matrix. So this is a recursive way of computing the determinant. And we can apply the formula again to each of these matrices. And eventually, we'll get down to 2 by 2 matrices, which we can compute. So let's look at an example. Again, let's take the matrix A equal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And we compute a determinant by picking I equal to 2. And we say that we are expanding the determinant along row 2. So this is now minus 1 to the 2 plus 1. And A 2 comma 1, that's 4. And then I have to take the determinant of the matrix with row 2 and column 1 deleted. And that's just 2, 3, 8, 9. Now the next one is minus 1 to the 2 plus 2, A 2, 2, that's 5. And multiply by the determinant of the matrix obtained from A by removing row 2 and column 2, that's 1, 3, 7, 9. And then finally, plus minus 1 to the 2 plus 3 times A 2 comma 3, and that's 6. And then multiply by the determinant of the matrix obtained from A by removing row 2 and column 3. And that's just 1, 2, 7, 8. Now, 2 by 2 determinants are easy to compute. So this is minus 4 times 2 times 9 minus 3 times 8 plus 5 times 1 times 9 minus 3 times 7 minus 6 times 1 times 8 minus 2 times 7. This is just 24 minus 60 plus 36, and that's equal to 0. So this formula up here expands the determinant along row I. But there's also another formula that expands along a column. So pick J from the set 1 up to n. Then the determinant of A is given by minus 1 to the 1 plus J, A1 comma J, determinant of A1 vertical bar J, plus minus 1 to the 2 plus J, A 2, j determinant of a 2 vertical bar j plus all the way up to minus 1 to the n plus j times a n, j determinant of a n vertical bar j. Now, out of convenience, one sometimes let ci, j to denote minus 1 to the I plus j times the determinant of a I vertical bar j. Then the formula for expanding along row I for the determinant can simply be written as this. And the formula for expanding along column j can also be written in a similar manner. Now, the reason why one might want to use the cofactor expansion is when the matrix has many zeros, things can really simplify. So for example, suppose my matrix look like this. So the entries are P0Q in the first row, A0B in the second row, and C1D in the third row. If I use the cofactor formula that expands along column 2, then the determinant of A is simply given by this, because all the other terms will be multiplied by these two zeros. What's left is a term corresponding to A32. So this again comes from expanding along column 2. And so if your matrix has lots of zeros, then you could exploit this fact, use the cofactor formula for appropriate choice of a column or row, and you can really reduce the number of computations that you have to perform.